Superman. Starring as Max Mencken, Kenneth Mars, deceitful glamour boy columnist for the Metropolis Daily Planet.
I hate Superman. Big show-off. Well, I like monogrammed shirts as well as the next guy. But that big red S, Superman. Anybody without a last name has got to be a little weird. Besides, he's pushy.
As Lois Lane, Leslie Warren, beautiful, luscious, spunky girl reporter.
I love Superman. It's not just that he looks so wonderful. He's so good. And when he picks me up in his arms and we fly over the city, oh, wow. He's so strong.
And as Sidney Carleton, Loretta Swit, cute as a button, sweet as pie, turkey gal Friday to Max Mencken.
I appreciate Superman, but I love Max Mencken. They say Max is a louse, but he's my louse. As for Superman, how could I possibly be interested in a guy whose clothes are prettier than mine?
As Dr. Abner Sedgwick, David Wayne, kindly, fatherly, lovable, mad scientist.
I am superior to Superman, and I intend to destroy him before your very eyes. You see, he stands between me and the one thing I want more than anything else. The world.
And introducing David Wilson as Clark Kent, meek and mild-mannered reporter for the Daily Planet.
Gee, they're holding up the First Metropolis Bank. Wish this gabby lady would get off the phone.
Who in reality is the Man of Steel, Superman.
Hi there, America, and friendly nations everywhere. Glad we could get together.
Chapter 1, Who He Is and How He Came to Be. Far out in space, the doomed planet Krypton explodes. The only survivor, an innocent babe. Placed in a rocket by his scientist father, moments before the cataclysm, the child is aimed toward the friendly planet Earth and lands fortunately in the heart of the good old USA, where it is discovered by a lonely, childless couple, the Kents.
Look, Mother. One innocent babe.
Oh, we've always wanted one of those.
Then by golly, we'll adopt him.
We'll name him Clark. Clark Kent.
Why not? Clark Kent. I like that. Aren't you happy, Mother? We have an innocent babe.
But they soon found that tiny Clark came from a race of super beings.
Oh, baby Clark has smashed through the nursery wall again.
The little Dickens. And look, Mother, he's flying. What are you knitting?
A little red cape.
Oh, won't he look good in that? A red cape. Deary me.
With the passing of his foster parents, Clark Kent, now grown to superb manhood, vows to use his titanic strength for the betterment of mankind. And so is created the Man of Steel. Faster than a speeding bullet.
Slow boat.
More powerful than a locomotive.
Sorry about that, Amtrak.
Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
No sweat.
What a man!
Thank heaven for Superman!
We need him.
Accusations.
A world of cheap sensations. A world with no foundation. And so we need him.
Yeah, I know.
Somehow he knows. We need him. We need him. Down to Superman. That's the end of the road to fight him. And that's why we need him.
mug that was mugging Uncle Meyer.
Saved him from the thug, yes he did. And when a bad situation goes dire, we need him. We need him. Yes, we do. We need him.
He brings the Arpin's Christmas turkey.
Christmas turkey. Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
He flew my asthmatic son to Albuquerque.
When the world morals stand is grow murky,
we need him.
We need him.
I need him.
They need me.
In this world of moral decay, we need him. We need him. In the world of evil and doubt, in these times of misery and crimes, we need him. We need him. We need him.
Stay tuned for Chapter 2, Merchant of Doom. Chapter 2, Merchant of Doom. Making his home in the vast city of Metropolis, Clark Kent works as a reporter for the Daily Planet.
I want all the news that's fit to print, and I want it now. Get that story.
Under the brilliant hand of Perry White, dynamic, fighting liberal editor, Clark Kent toils diligently in journalism's vineyards alongside his fellow reporters.
Gee, Lois, you look nifty today.
Hmm? Oh, Clark, have you been there all along?
Yeah, for 4 hours. Hey, baby.
Take a gander at this lead item for my column, Max Mencken's Metropolis.
You stood me up last night. Why should I?
Because I'm gorgeous. What scarlet cape schlemiel with an S on his chest is becoming a menace to commercial aviation?
Oh, Max, what are you up to?
I'm gonna bring that big phony down to earth if it's the last thing I do. Stop the presses! Stop the presses!
Gee, Max must have a hot item.
Oh, Clark, have you been there all along?
Yeah, for 4 hours and 40 seconds.
Oh. Oh, I'm so wrapped up finishing my Superman story. Superman. That's all I ever write about.
Kind of a funny attitude, considering how many times he saved your life.
Saving my life is our entire relationship. He never does anything meaningful. He never says he loves me.
Oh, how I wish I weren't in love with Superman. A wasted life is all I've got with Superman.
Anywhere you want to go, free.
747 will show more attention.
Does he ever hold me? Has he ever told me he could care?
He could care.
Tell me, please, when will he learn it's not some silly fly-by-night affair? So I know that I should find myself. Give my love to as I know I can. A homie type who'll stay around. A guy with both feet on the ground. But till he comes, my heart is bound to a super.
then. Scoop! Oh, stop the presses! Oh, Scoop! Scoop, stop the presses!
Hey, would you guys kind of slow the presses down a little, please?
Meanwhile, far beneath a deserted warehouse, secret entrance to the underworld kingdom of Mafioso, others plot the destruction of the Man of Steel.
Make way for his big boss, this! Make way for King Big Boss, the Fifth!
First, the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ready? Go.
I pledge allegiance to the mobs of the United Hoods of the Underworld. One family, all invisible, with larceny and rub-outs for all.
Okay, sit down.
Sit down.
My fellow Hoods, let me make one thing perfectly clear. There's somebody we gotta take out. Somebody's given crime a very bad name.
Marlon Brando?
No, you dummy. I'm talking about the big time. I'm putting out a contract on Superman.
Superman? But how can we rub him out?
That's for you slobs to figure out. But I tell you this. If that bum is bothering me by the end of this week, you'll all be sent up to the big state pen in the sky. You got me?
Oh, boss, that's...
Ah, now, listen. For the mug who rubs Superman out, there's a very big reward.
A reward, your boss?
What? Florida!
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 Oh, but your boss, the Superman, he's special.
Yeah, geez, can we do it?
Come here.
Come here.
Come here.
Look out that window. What do you see?
A streetlight.
A hooker. A mugger.
No use, dummies. Raise your horizons. Higher, higher. Now what do you see?
A streetlight.
A hooker. A mugger.
It's a swell country, land of opportunity. It's a swell country for hoods like you and me.
Our nation's founding fathers. I really love those guys, 'cause they're the guys what came up
with free enterprise. It's a rich country
full of all the trusting souls.
It's a swell country without no gun control. It's a swell country, every man is on his own.
You can reach greatness.
Just look at Al Capone. Our lawyers are terrific, they know just what to try. Our politicians are the best that you can buy.
If the feds grab you, you can always cop a plea. It's a swell country, from sea to shining sea.
It's a free country, you can travel far and wide.
It's a big country, with lots of spots to hide. That poor lad with ambition, who's working night and day,
he's gonna climb that ladder and control L.A. It's the best country where a crook can get ahead. It will be better when Superman is dead, dead, dead.
Dead.
and we mean to keep it free. Free for hijackers and graft and larceny. We really love this country with all those trusting souls. It's a swell country without no gun control. It's the best country where a crook can get ahead. It will be better when so.
Meanwhile, back at the Daily Planet, a trap is being laid for Superman.
And your job is to get it. Now!
I beg your pardon.
If you're looking for a job, see Mr. White.
Excuse me, Miss Lane, I'm terribly sorry.
If you want a job, see Mr. White.
Oh, I think you misunderstand. I am Dr. Abner Sedgwick.
Dr. Abner Sedgwick? Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't recognize you.
Well, that's quite understandable. I'm not exactly what you'd call a celebrity.
Oh, you're too modest. Why, when anybody speaks of the Metropolis Institute of Technology, they really mean Dr. Abner Sedgwick.
You're very kind.
Do sit down.
Thank you. I have come on a matter of utmost urgency.
Oh?
Could we speak alone?
But we are alone.
No, I mean...
Huh? Oh, Clark, have you been there all along?
I'll let you speak in private. I got caught in a typewriter.
Oh, just think, Dr. Abner Sedgwick. Oh, I was so disappointed that you didn't win the Nobel Prize last year.
Well, as we say in academia, you can't win them all.
Oh, but you haven't won any. Did I say something?
Oh, no. As a matter of fact, I was overjoyed when Dr. Hashimoto of Tokyo won the prize. We were both working on negative neutrons, you know. But he announced his findings first, the juicy, slurping little... Actually, a more charming little neutron negator you could never hope to meet.
Well, what's the urgent problem?
Metropolis is doomed.
Oh?
Yes, you know that new $20 million death ray that we installed at the university last year to put down student uprisings.
Gee, no, I don't. But what about it?
Well, it's gone absolutely berserk. And in no time at all, Metropolis will be reduced to a graveyard.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
But what can I, a girl reporter, do?
Well, the only person who can save us is Superman. Now, you are his friend. You must contact him at once.
I'll try. Let me see. Supermarket, super cleaners, super...
Lois doesn't need to call me. Super hearing. This looks like a job for...
Superman.
So, Superman has fallen into my trap. Soon he will face a ray so powerful that even on its shakedown test, it was capable of obliterating an internal revenue agent at a range of 1,000 miles. And Superman will be only inches away. Oh, my goodness gracious.
Gotta stop that death ray before it turns the city into a graveyard.
Will Superman make it in time? Stay tuned for Chapter 3, Superman Makes It. Chapter 3, Superman Makes It. Superman races toward MIT, where in moments a monstrous death ray will destroy the entire city. Will he make it?
Made it. Now, to tame that death ray.
Oh, my dear.
Oh, dear, dear. Oh, my dear. Oh, my dear. Oh.
I rang the bell. Door was locked.
Who can hear with all this racket? It's about to explode. Oh, Superman, can you save us all from destruction?
Sure.
Are you all right, Superman?
Just a little singed.
Well, put a little butter on it when you get home.
Right.
Oh, Superman, what can I say? What can anyone say except thank you? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Up, up, and away!
Okay, down there. I've made the city safe again for clean living. Wrap up another one for Superman.
Yes, yes, I'm getting it down. Superman destroyed the death ray. He saved Metropolis. Oh, wow, what a story. Oh, excuse me, Dr. Sedgwick, but this is what we girl reporters live for. Scoop! Stop the presses!
So, Superman has destroyed the death ray. Think I mind? Not at all. It's all part of my master plan to bring him down. Oh, he's a great hero now. But the higher he flies, the further he has to fall. Now, you may ask, why do I want to obliterate Superman? In order to rule the world. You may ask, why do I want to rule the world? In order to obliterate Sweden. You may ask why I want to obliterate Sweden. For revenge. To pay those meatballs back for never having awarded me the Nobel Prize. 10 times I was runner-up. 10 times! But always. Hey, been sorry, Dr. Sedgwick, but you blew it again. Look at me. Look at me! A 10-time Nobel Prize loser! Oh. In 1938, I earned my PhD with a masterful hypothesis in colloid chemistry. I was getting set to publish. When much to my surprise, Richard T. Zsigmondy won the Nobel Prize. And for what? For work in the heterogeneous nature of colloid solutions. My field, my colloids! In 1949, I thought I had it made. My work in light diffusion put my colleagues in the shade. But then my hopes were shattered by some Hindu in Ceylon. They gave the prize in physics to Sushandra V. Raman. And for what? Work in light diffusion? The Raman effect? It should have been the Sedgwick effect! Revenge! Revenge! I'll have it on them all. No single slight will I forget. I'll show no mercy, you can bet. They'll all get theirs the day I get revenge. That dopey Wolfgang Pauli with his work in fission. I used to help that punk with long division. And fare me for his brilliant neutron system. He wouldn't know a neutron if it kissed him. But the thing that really drove me to a fury, they gave the prize to Harold Urey. The shocking thing about the matter is,
my heavy hydrogen was heavier than his. Revenge, revenge, that's all I look for now. I'll make them wince and cringe and cry. I'll spit in their collective eye. I'll have one thing before I die.
What is the one terrible thing that Dr. Sedgwick will have before he dies? Stay tuned for Chapter 4, Sedgwick's Revenge. What is the one terrible thing that Dr. Sedgwick will have before he dies?
Revenge!
And I'll have it on that symbol of goodness, Superman.
Oh, yeah, well, will you?
Huh? Huh? Why, blast you, I'll... Oh,
I hope you're not mistaken. You see, I had a slight upset stomach.
Oh, no, I'm not mistaken. Not at all. So you hate Superman, too, right?
Join the club. You?
Me, your wife. If it wasn't for that big salami and blue drawers, I'd be number one in this town. Everybody used to read my column before he came along. I was even going into politics. Now he gets all the attention. Not to mention Lois Lane.
Perhaps you could be of some assistance to me. Join me clandestinely in 1 hour at this address.
MIT, the Metropolis Institute of Technology.
In 1 hour, I promise not to keep you after midnight.
Very interesting. What's interesting, Max?
Oh, nothing, sweetheart, nothing. Oh, by the way, something important came up. I'm gonna have to call off our date tonight.
Max, we haven't had a date in a week.
Sorry, baby. I know how that must hurt. But important things are starting to happen. I've got big plans. Filth mouth.
Oh, poor Sydney.
Hey, sweetheart. How about a late date tonight? I'll be through after midnight. Just call me Cinderella.
Oh, I have other plans.
Oh, yeah? What? That blue and red super sucker? Is he going to carry off in the clouds, huh?
Are you referring to Superman?
Oh, baby, baby. When are you going to get smart? My name is Max. Fly me.
You know, you're really quite a dish. Yeah, what a guy. Mike Paul. Delish. You've got an awful lot of class. Oh, my, but you're packed. As solid as a knish. But every time I make a pass, I get the well-known freezeroo. What's the bit, kid? I admit, kid, I can't figure you. You're the woman for the man who has everything. Let me show you how to live. Girls who get are girls who give. You're the woman for the man who has everything. I'm a man who has everything. Everything but you.
Oh, come on, Lois, sweetheart. You know the old chemistry's working, right?
Humphrey Bogart.
Wrong.
At every opening night, I'm there. Head waiters know me everywhere. Of course, it's freebies all the way. A check for me, they wouldn't dare. A chick is seen with me today. Tomorrow, Playboy starts to call. Just relax, kid. This is Max, kid. Don't give me a stall.
Max?
Did you ever know I used to be a hooper, sweetheart? A hooper.
Hooper? You mean the rear end of a horse act?
Hilarious. Dance.
Hey.
to get some sand in the office.
Shh, shh, shh.
You're the woman for the man who has everything. Why not give old Max a try? He's a pretty decent guy. You're the woman for the man who has everything. And for the man who has everything, only the best will do. So why can't I have you?
Be good to yourself, sweetheart.
Will Lois Lane forget Superman and surrender her virtue to the conniving Max Mencken?
Get lost, Max.
At last, a breakthrough.
Oh!
Well, all right. All right, but you'll be sorry. You and your klutz of steel. So long, you super sucker lover.
And good riddance. I've had it with Max.
Oh, that's the spirit, Sydney. Oh, I wish I had the courage to feel the same way about Superman. I'm tired of waiting around for him.
Then say it, Lois.
All right. I've had it with Superman. Well, I guess I'll go home and hope that he drops by.
Oh, why don't you find yourself a nice guy? Like Clark Kent.
Who's that?
He sits at the desk next to yours.
Oh, what? Where? Oh, him. Oh, yes. No.
No?
Are you coming?
No, I promised Max I'd finish typing his column.
Oh, all right. Good night.
Clark Kent. He's not so bad. He's not so good. At least he's always around.
Perhaps not, Sydney. Perhaps Clark Kent won't always be around. For at this very moment, powerful forces of evil plot Superman's destruction. Stay tuned for Chapter 5, The Net Tightens. Chapter 5, The Net Titans.
For Superman! Titans! For Superman! Titans! For Superman!
Hold it!
What? We got a problem!
What?
The problem is with Superman, this ain't no chitin rod.
Oh, what are you going to tell us that now?
Gee, spoil sport. We were having so much fun, too.
What do you want from me?
There must be some way we could rub out Superman.
Maybe we could form a union and picket him to death.
It wouldn't help.
It wouldn't hide.
You guys don't understand. Don't you see Superman is, it's a kind of phrase, invulnerable.
I can't take this anymore. I can't stand this.
What?
All this invulnerability. You think you got problems? I can't even pronounce it.
What?
Invulnerable.
Oh.
I said it.
He's not doing it. Uh-huh. I got an idea.
What?
Why don't we go see a doctor?
A doctor?
A doctor, a dentist?
No, a doctor, a professor. The guy over at the college, one invented the debt rate thing.
Oh, that doctor.
Yeah, that doctor. Why don't we go over there? Maybe he's got something even better than a debt rate thing. We go over there, pay him a purely social visit.
Later, in Dr. Sedgwick's laboratory on the MIT campus.
Wow. Who would have thought that kindly old Dr. Sedgwick was in reality a mad scientist?
That's strictly off the record, you understand. I won't print a thing.
But you said you'd worked out a plan to destroy Superman.
Max. Good guy's plan. Bad guy's scheme.
What's your scheme?
Be prepared to be dazzled by its brilliance. Are you ready?
Am I ready?
Are you ready? The way to destroy Superman is to have Superman destroy himself.
You mean to say that Superman would destroy himself?
I mean to say that Superman would destroy himself.
Ah, I see. You mean that Superman would destroy himself?
I mean that Superman would destroy himself.
Meanwhile, in the nearly deserted city room of the Daily Planet.
Oh, gee, everybody's gone home.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, Sydney, I didn't mean
it. I know you didn't mean. To you, if Lois Lane isn't here, everybody's gone home. What did you do to your hand?
It's a little burn.
Ooh, you want me to kiss it and make it feel better?
Oh, come on, Sydney, cut it out.
Kemp, you know, you could be an attractive man with a little help from a friend. Haircut, simply terrible. Necktie, the worst. Bearing, just unbearable. What to tackle first still? You've got possibilities, though you're horribly square. I see possibilities. Underneath there's something there. Collar, pure Peoria. That hat, oh no, I'm not Queen Victoria. That suit has to go still. You've got possibilities. Let us give it a try. I see possibilities. Maybe more than meet the eye. Don't back away. Improvable, it won't take long. Mountains can be movable if the spirit's strong. Yes, you've got possibilities. Takes a woman to tell. I see possibilities. Let me pry you from your shell. Be shy when I get through. Come on and roar, you tiger, you. Come where, way down deep in you, there's life, no doubt. It's just been asleep in you. Let me bring it out, yes. Red hot possibilities. Why be shy and ill at ease? I see possibilities. You don't even know.
Will Clark Kent find happiness with a new love? Stay tuned for Chapter 6. Clark Kent finds happiness. Chapter 6. Clark Kent finds happiness.
Gee, Sydney. Would you believe suddenly I'm happy?
Meanwhile...
You mean Superman would destroy himself.
I mean, Superman would destroy himself.
How?
That's a good question, Max. I thought you'd never ask. Now, beneath that powerful exterior, there is a simple ego and an id, just as there is in you and me. And there is where he is vulnerable. Now, we must place him in the situation where he will disgrace himself.
Yes, of course. What situation?
Tomorrow, at my behest, the university is going to honor Superman for having destroyed the death ray, which I conveniently arranged. Now, what would happen if some terrible calamity were to befall a metropolis at the very moment when he's taking his bows?
What?
The public would be outraged.
Yes, Superman would look like a fool.
Precisely, Max. And that's where you come in. You and your column. You must arrange to see that the press and the other media lean very heavily on Superman.
Yes. With a setup like this, we could turn him into a bum overnight.
Well, he couldn't take it. He'd fall apart. He'd collapse inwardly. Ergo, he would...
Wait a minute. Superman would destroy himself.
Bravo, Max. We're thinking alike. Rotten. Oh, Max, Max. How fortunate we found each other.
Oh, Abner, Abner. Partners.
Together, we will rule the world.
Yeah.
But Sweden's mine!
Oh, sure.
My heart's pounding with the glory now before me.
Gee, Doc, I'm beginning to see, Doc.
My soul quivers with the glory now in view.
Hell, Doc, it's beginning to gel. We'll cut this town up like a great big cake, Doc. Shake, Doc. Well, it's me and you. You got what I need, baby. You got it and how. You got what I need, baby. Together we can scale the heights, and I mean right now. You got what it takes, sweetie. All the way from A to Z. Yes, you got what I need, baby. And from now on, baby, you've got me. From now on, Dr. Sedgwick, that's gonna be you and me.
Oh, don't call me Dr. Sedgwick. Call me Abner.
Abner? Do I have to? Well,
tell you the truth, Doc. You're just a teensy-weensy bit weird. But you're cute. Cute.
You're loaded with class, baby. La creme de la creme.
Let's step on the gas, baby.
Oh, Abner, you're a million laughs.
And Max, you're a gem.
You got it in space, lovey. You're a pal, no belly. Mickey Mouse.
Here comes the new team. Mister, we'll be great. Just wait and see. You got what I need, baby. And from now on, baby, don't mean maybe. From now on, baby, you got me.
You have an appointment.
Is the doctor in?
I am the doctor.
Consider yourself kidnapped.
Yeah.
But will you?
We want you to use your God-given gifts to rub somebody out, see?
Who?
Superman.
Max.
Yes. I think I have found something I've always wanted.
What?
My very own henchman.
Next day. Clark Kent kissing Lois Lane? Can this be true? Stay tuned for Chapter 7. Oh, Clark, have you been there all along? Stay tuned for Chapter 7. Oh, Clark, have you been there all along?
Oh, Clark, have you been there all along?
Yeah. You just never noticed. I guess it was going out and talking to Sydney that changed me.
Oh, Lois. You see, Clark and I found out right away we weren't right for each other. But he's a terrific guy, and he's nuts about you, kid. Mm. All he needed was a little confidence in himself, and I guess I gave it to him.
Yeah, all I needed was a little confidence in myself, and I guess you gave that to me, Sydney.
Oh, Clark.
Oh, Sydney, you're swell.
Oh, Lois,
oh, Sydney, what can I say?
Oh, Clark, you don't have to say anything.
Oh, Clark.
Oh, God.
What is this? Rosebud? A sleigh? Nobody will believe that. You're fired. Now. Kent, I want you in my office. Now.
Huh? Oh, yeah. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Oh, Clark. Me? Clark Kent? Oh, I don't believe it. And yet, I know he's no Superman. And yet, but I never wanted a simple guy like Clark. And yet,
well, well, look at me, the girl who wanted the unattainable man. But now suddenly, life has handed me a totally different plan. And something in me melts, and what I've always wanted turns out to be something else. What I've always wanted, what I've always wanted.
that story! Get that story now!
Yeah. Metropolis Institute of Technology is honoring Superman. They're naming a building after him, and the chief wants me to cover the story.
Oh, that's wonderful, dear.
No, it isn't. Hmm? I mean, Superman's supposed to be there, too, and how is he going to be there when I'm supposed... Oh, Lois. Look, no matter what happens, believe in me.
All right.
I just caught a cold.
I believe you. I believe you. Just
then you cover. Then you cover the story.
Oh, Clark, I...
Look, one day, maybe, I'll be able to explain.
Because then I'd...
Meanwhile...
Do you all understand the plan?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where are the bombs? Oh. Oh, that is lovely. A Brunswick. Now, carefully, take them across town and place them under City Hall.
They have to go off at exactly the moment when Superman is accepting his award at the university. Have you got me?
I got you.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Are you positive?
I'm positive.
Ooh, I hope you got me.
Chaps, chitons for Superman.
Chitons for Superman. Chitons for Superman.
Will Superman fall into this dastardly trap? Stay tuned for Chapter 8, Superman Trapped. Chapter 8, Superman Trapped. Later at the university, a gathering of students cheer the arrival of Superman.
Sorry I was late. There were some Boy Scouts lost in the woods. I found them.
Oh!
It's really quite an honor to be here today to have this
laundry
thing. And laundry named after me. I've always said that cleanliness was next to superpower.
Superman, as you can see, we're all your fans.
Yeah, those are pretty keen shirts. Where'd you get them?
Joe here did them.
Oh, come on, Jerry.
Tell me.
I'm an artist, Superman, and all I want to do is draw pictures of you.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm an author, Superman, and all I want to do is write stories about you.
Thanks, kids.
Let us show our appreciation by the simple dedication of this laundry, which is to be named after you. Use it whenever you wish, or oftener if necessary.
Yeah. Fellow friends in Metropoles, thanks. Thank you very much. I love this city. Oh.
He really means it, folks. He really does.
I love the people in this city. I love the parks and the playgrounds. I mean, this is my city. This is our city. I vow to protect and defend our town from anyone who might try to do it any harm.
The Metropolis City Hall has been mysteriously blown up. We repeat, the Metropolis City Hall has been blown up. We're standing by for further details. We switch you now to Ray Clive in Master Control.
Fortunately, we are able to bring you some instant analysis of this terrible event. We have here in our studio the noted columnist and well-known expert on City Hall explosions, Max Mencken. Well, Mr. Mencken, what do you make of this City Hall explosion?
Well, it exploded. That's for certain. In fact, I don't think there can be any doubt whatever about that. City Hall has exploded.
I guess you're right.
But I have one little question to ask. Where was Superman? Huh? Why did he fail to stop this terrible catastrophe? Oh, my fellow Americans, it is at a time like this when I wish I were sitting there in Washington in that Oval Office. If nominated, I would accept. When elected, I would serve in all humility. There is only one man who can accept the blame for this public outrage. And that man is Superman. He was our blue and red dogging linebacker. And he let the team down when the team needed him the most.
Thank you, Mr. Mencken, for putting everything into focus. And now, go out and have a nice day.
Superman! Say it isn't so!
And where were you? Basking in the dedication of your laundry. Why weren't you there?
Wait a minute, please, listen to me. It's...
Boo, boo, boo.
Stay tuned for Chapter 9, Get Lost, Superman. Chapter 9, Get Lost, Superman.
Superman blows it. How about that?
And I wrote the story. I don't think even Krypton would take him back.
Superman,
baby.
In case you haven't noticed it, you've had it.
From now on, there's no stopping Mrs. Minkin's big boy, Max. It's a smile. It's a glow. It's Supermax.
Oh, Max, for crying out loud.
Yeah. Oh, well, maybe I am a little premature. But only a little, sweetheart. Only a little. Want to get on the ground floor, sweetheart? Write a book. My years with Max Minkin. We could make a fortune.
I'd like to write a book. You're a subject I could really sink my teeth into.
Why, a book like that would be the hottest thing between two covers ever.
Which is more than I can say for the subject.
Very funny, very funny. Yeah. Ho, ho, ho.
You know, Max, someone in this world thinks you're wonderful. Someone sees how marvelous you are. You don't know how much this someone worships you. The moment you saw you, how your heart began to pound. It was not infatuation. No, it was much more profound. Then you smile, then you tremble, and the thunder rolled above. On that day you can't forget, as you lit your cigarette, was love. Ooh, do you dig you? Ooh, you're gone on you. It's so touching to see.
Here he is, Doc. We got him for you.
Stop.
There he is.
So right over low.
There. Go on here. Don't yell.
Now get out of here. Get out of here. Go on.
Not you!
Get out.
Abner, does this mean our song and dance days are over?
Max Mencken, yes. Did you think you could fool me? My computer has solved the identity of Superman.
Oh, yes? Well, that's very interesting information.
Superman is a reporter on the Daily Planet.
Oh, yeah?
He works in the city room.
Oh, yeah?
He is incessantly thinking about Lois Lane.
Oh, yeah?
Now, who is faster than a speeding bullet? Who is more powerful than an express train? Who can leap over the tallest building in a single bound? You can, Max Mencken, or should I say, Superman?
Don't shoot! Oh, don't shoot, Doc! That jerk computer's wrong! Wrong!
The computer says it's never wrong.
You ever see 2001? You know what happens to smart aleck computers? Honest to Pete, Tuck, I'm not Superman.
Well, I do think about Lois Lane a little, but I think about me a lot.
I mean, look, I'm weak as a cat, Doc. If I was Superman, would those guys be able to knock me out? Would I be afraid of your gun? Huh? Huh?
Well, the son of a gun. Just a minute here. Clark Kent also works in the city room. Clark Kent is always mooning about Lois Lane.
Clark Kent? I forgot about him.
The computer says it forgot about him, too.
Everybody does.
Well, goodness gracious. Clark Kent is Superman.
Hold the phone.
You mean to say that Clark Kent is Superman?
I mean to say that Clark Kent is Superman.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Well, you know about that. I always thought Kent flew a little, but not that way.
Well, now that we know his identity, we'll break him. Come on.
Where?
To Clark Kent's apartment.
Superman, you son of a gun. You've had it.
Stay tuned for Chapter 10, Curtains for Superman. Chapter 10, Curtains for Superman. Later, in Clark Kent's apartment.
Oh. Well, I'm late for the office. Oh, boy, I forgot to get dressed.
Oh, everything's all mixed up. What's the matter? Am I losing control? Why'd everybody have to turn on me? Darn. One little mistake. Why can't the strongest man in the world be the happiest man in the world? Why does the strongest man in the world have the heaviest heart in the world? Why must I, the man of steel, feel as helpless as a man of straw? They used to hold me in such awe. Now their cheers have turned to jeers. Why must the strongest man in the world be the bluest man? Tell me why.
Kent suit and face the world. Here am I, the man of steel, hiding out here like a timid mouse. Why I couldn't
Finish off Superman.
You really think your dastardly plan will work?
In 2 hours' time, I will have reduced Superman to an emotional vegetable.
Sedgwick.
Good afternoon, Mr. Kent. Or should I say, Superman? May I come in?
Oh, wow. My identity's been discovered.
Relax. I'm here to help you. You do need help, you know. Shut the door. Lie down on that couch. I'll sit here. Now, wouldn't you be happier out of that Clark Kent masquerade?
Yeah.
Well, then take it off.
Yeah.
Meanwhile...
Hello, Lois? This is Clark. Clark Kent. Look, Lois, my cold is worse. Can you come over right away and bring some chicken soup?
Ah, that costume, what a prop. Your sick ego conceived of that to separate you from the common man whom you despise.
Oh, no, no, no.
And that name, Superman. Hmm? Oh, pathetic little boy playing his sad, sick little jokes, getting his wretched little kicks from the adulation of the masses.
No, the masses really love me. Wouldn't you want to fly by?
Flying is just a symbol of frustration. Huh? Oh, you're a sick, demented creature, Superman.
Demented?
Did it ever occur to you that that X-ray vision is just another word for voyeurism?
Oh, no. Well, it isn't my fault. I was rejected as a child. I was shot up in a rocket.
Oh, of course, blame them if the truth were known. You deserted them. You flew away and allowed them to be blown to smithereens.
Oh, Mommy, Mommy! I didn't mean it.
And that so-called good you do. Why, that's just to alleviate your terrible, haunting guilt. Huh? Superman, you're nothing but a freak.
A freak? I'm a freak?
Well, this has been a very productive session.
I'm a freak.
I have other appointments.
Oh, no, I'm a freak.
Did it work? We'll see. Now for the final test. Did you call Lois?
Yeah. Here she comes now.
Oh, quick, through the fire door.
Clark! Clark! Clark?
Lois?
Superman! Oh, Superman, I'm so glad you're here. I must talk to you. Oh.
Now, you know, I've always loved you. But that's different now.
You too?
Oh, it's not because of City Hall. I've found another. One who can return my love. It's Clark Kent. What I've always wanted. What I've always wanted. Just to be a wife. That corny life is what I've always wanted.
Now nobody loves me.
Oh, Superman, that's not true. Yeah. Well, everybody loves you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, now, there are all kinds of love. There's the love of a little boy for his dog, and there's the love of a man and a woman.
I don't deserve love. I'm frustrated. I'm irresponsible. I'm guilty. You're in love with Clark Kent?
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna break him in two. What am I talking about? I don't know what I am, who I am.
Well, you're Superman.
No.
You can fly and bend steel and catch bullets and...
No. My powers are gone.
Oh, that's nonsense. Your powers are not gone.
Mm-hmm.
Superman, you look at me. Superman, you look at me.
No,
Superman,
no,
look
no.
At me.
Thanks, Lois. I needed that.
Now you look at me with that magnificent X-ray vision of yours.
Yeah. X-ray vision still works. I can see you perfectly.
Oh, wonderful. There you...
Oh,
God. Turn it off. Turn it off.
Yuck. Bones. Sedgwick was right. I'm a freak.
Grab the gun and report.
Oh, Superman, save me. Save me.
I can't. I'm paralyzed.
Grab the gun.
Freaked out.
Oh, it's all psychosomatic, but there's no time for therapy. You must save me now.
How?
Remember who you are, what you are. Fling open the window, crying out as usual. Off and away.
You hang in there, Lois. I'm coming. Hi-yo, Silver.
Metropolis's huge and impersonal Warren G. Harding Memorial Bridge, a man of battered steel, slowly approaches. Sorry, I let you down, humanity. Goodbye, world! Is this finally the end of Superman? Stay tuned for the 11th and final chapter, Superman Triumphant. Chapter 11, Superman Triumphant.
We university types, after a home game, always celebrate with hot toddies. Have one.
Hot toddies? Well, Roddy Rara says boom ba.
No, thanks. I never drink hot toddies. They give me the hiccups.
Here she is.
Dr. Sedgwick, thank heavens you're here.
We are joined by the lady reporter. Won't you sit down, please?
Oh, thank you.
Strap her in!
Oh, I never would have believed these men, but now I know it's true. Oh, you too, Max. Oh, Dr. Sedgwick, you of all people, a mad scientist.
Well, we all have our little quirks, but you'll never live to tell about it, because beneath that chair is 100 pounds of TNT. Oh. Soon, it and this entire laboratory, which contains evidence against me, will be blown to smithereens. Then, with a pooped Superman, I'll be able to rule the world.
Oh, Dr. Sedgwick, you may think you've won, but let me tell you, I'm not finished yet. Superman won't let me die. He will plummet from the sky. Why, he's on his way, I'll bet. Any moment he'll appear, and he'll whisk me out of here. No, sir, I'm not finished yet. You've tied my hands, but you can't tie my spirit. You'll find we journalists are hard to scare. You may be going home before you know it. When Superman arrives, he'll throw you there. No, I'm not finished yet. You can giggle all you please. Soon you'll all be on your knees. Men like you will always fail. You will end your lives in jail. Good will triumph, don't forget. No, sir,
gee, Doc, aren't we showing a little too high a profile crime-wise? I mean, heck, there's no point in hurting Lois, is there?
Oh, Max, deep down I always knew you were decent.
Shh, I have a reputation to uphold.
Max, I'm afraid you're no longer of any use to me. Grab him, put him in that chair.
Yakety, yakety.
Oh, Max, I'm sorry.
Right over here. Get the ice. Where?
In the filing cabinet.
In the filing cabinet. Get where?
Under eye.
Under eye.
Now take off his shoes.
Shoes?
Place his feet on that block of ice.
No.
Now, there are delicate electric sensors in that chair attached to the dynamite beneath this chair. One violent action, such as a sneeze, will set it off.
But why?
I no longer need you, Max. I want the world all to myself. No divvies.
Oh, you dirt. Get in there.
Don't. It's okay, Doc.
Oh.
We've got to get out of here.
Get that,
Oh. Follow me. Oh.
Now dice, Doc.
Yeah, who needs you, Sedgwick?
If anybody takes over the world, it'll be King Big Boss the Fifth. And now, may we present the 1975 Bad Guy Nobel Prize.
Prize? A prize, prize, prize. Goodness gracious, who will win it?
May I have the envelope, please?
With pleasure.
And for his extraordinary work in ridding the world of Superman, the winner is Dr. Sedgwick!
What's the prize?
The prize is a one-way ticket to Palookasville. Tie him up, strap him in that chair.
Thank you. Hit
it!
Superman, hell, I'd settle for a shot of vitamin C.
Meanwhile, back on the Warren G. Harding Memorial Bridge.
I blew it again. I forgot. Super lungs.
Hey, Joe! Isn't that Superman?
Hey, Superman!
Hey,
oh, sorry,
Superman.
Joe,
what are you doing here?
Now, I'm nothing but a freak.
Sure.
What do you mean, sure?
Hey, we knew you were all along.
You did? You still idolized me?
Hey, there's nothing wrong with being a freak.
That's right. Just means you're a little different than the rest.
Different, you mean better?
No. Just like more so.
Right. Like, take Michelangelo. Only a freak would have taken 4 years just to paint a ceiling.
And what about Christopher Columbus? Now, he was such a freak that they had to send him off on a boat.
That's right. And Honest Abe Lincoln. Hey, freeing the brothers was the freakiest thing of the 1800s.
Yeah.
Huh.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with being a freak, man, as long as you freak in the right direction.
I've always tried to do good.
Then, man, what are you so uptight about?
Yeah, now that you put it that way, I'm beginning to feel more like Superman.
Yeah.
Hey, wait a minute.
Wow, all right.
I am Superman. Hey, Jerry, Joe, what can I say? Without you, there wouldn't be a Superman.
Forget it, Superman. You just do your thing.
Right on. Lois is in danger. I'm gonna split. Up, up.
With all them odds, there's gotta be a chew someplace.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Right.
So fast.
It's Superman.
Hi, Lo.
How'd you find us?
My freaky X-ray vision.
Let's get him, guys.
Yeah.
Exercise, take that, pow, and that, zap. Let's see what you can do. You boys, pow, are good, bam. I like a crook who really tries. Come on, pow, let's go. You'll learn a trick or two. Gee, it's funny that only a moment ago. Pow, bam, zonk, I doubted myself. And all that was right. But now I see the light. Oh no, you don't wham. I'll show you babies who I am. Pow, whack, song, crunch, bam. Don't you do that again. Good night, sweet dreams. So sorry to mess up your plans, but now you know. Splat, pow, don't fool around. Wham, zow, with Superman.
Oh, Superman, you're wonderful.
Yeah, I know. Gotta get you out of here, Lois.
Oh, how about us, Muscle Bound?
Women and children before villains.
Go pump your biceps.
Yeah. Have some of this hop toddy. It'll keep you from sneezing until I get back. Come on, Lois.
Oh, wow! Up, up, and away!
You You drank that hot toddy?
Well, sure, my chills are gone.
You fool, a hiccup is as dangerous as a sneeze.
Oh, no.
Oh, hold your breath. Put your head in a sack. Let me scare you.
What scare? I'm terrified already.
Oh, sky high. They're done for.
Not if I can catch them with my free hand before they hit the ground.
Oh, Superman, you're terrific.
Yeah, I know.
Next day...
Oh, Max, it's gorgeous. Whatever happened to make you change?
Oh, gosh, Sydney, I don't know. It all came over me in a flash.
Oh, so...
That explosion caused partial amnesia, blocked out all his badness. Also caused him to forget Superman's identity and turned him into a valuable member of society. It's the same thing with Dr. Sedgwick.
Science editor for the Daily Planet. I just know I'll win a Pulitzer Prize.
Lois.
Oh, Clark, have you been there all along? Oh, Clark. Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I'm still in love with Superman.
I just got this cable from Steffens in Moscow. I have seen the future, and it works. That's no story. Here's the story. The Harding Dam just broke, and a gigantic tidal wave is headed toward Metropolis. Get that story now!
This it looks like a job for...
Superman, starring... Also starring as Superman's friends,
accusations, a world of cheap sensations, a world with no foundation. Let's start again.
Yeah, I know.
Son to Albuquerque.
You look like that.